baby. No, I said I wasn't ready for this, but you're something I can't resist and I won't let go. Oh, darling, what if all this time you were meant to be mine? It's a funny thing. So on top of this ring, you can have your house on a hill, and I'll build your little windmill. We can pray for time to stand still. Gotta love your soul. And we can fill that home with kids. Sit back in rocking chair, reminisce. This ain't no temporary bliss, baby. Let me know. And we can grow on. Hey, baby, hey, baby, I think I've changed my mind. What you doing for the rest of my life? Oh, what do you say? Oh, darling, wondering if you feel the same. Would you take my last name and say you love me so? But before that, you should know. Baby, you need to know. You can have your house on a hill, and I'll build your little windmill. We can pray for time to stand still. Gotta love your soul. And we can fill that home with kids. Sit back in rocking chair, reminisce. This ain't no temporary bliss, baby. Let me know. And we on a hill, and I'll build your little windmill. We can pray for time to stand still. Gotta love your soul. Can't wait to fill that home with kids. Sit back in a rocking chair, reminisce. This ain't no temporary bliss, baby. Let me.
Support from all those gathered. Zach and Tori cannot thank each of you enough. enough for the many years of love and support, which is continued by your presence and witness in today's ceremony. The bridegroom would also like to recognize the support of those who are not here in body, but in spirit. Wayne Stone and Jed Stephens, Joe Stephens, affectionately known as Pat. While they are missed, we know that they remain with us, and it is on days like these that we feel them even closer. A wedding day doesn't just happen. The multitude of things that must come together to create a wedding is significant. Many choices are made along the way, and rarely does every plan work out. As many here know, planning a wedding is tough. Whether it's remembering your sister's lactose intolerant one week before the wedding and having to change the menu, or on a nice spring day we have the hottest day of the year. There's always a curveball or two. There are even those days where you just wanted to escape it all and run to the courthouse and be done. But it's important to remember the constants throughout the plan. Those things that no matter how tough it got, they were there to keep everything moving forward. The first and most critical of these is the love you share with each other. I'm talking about the unique love and understanding of the other that makes it obvious that the difficulty is worth it. Now, not some idealistic romanticized version, but the apparent existing love between you two that I and everyone here have witnessed as you have grown together. The love that loves each other even when they do not love themselves is the love that brings everyone here today to celebrate. And speaking of everyone, it is the people here's witness that are the second constant that matters. Everyone here today in some capacity has helped to create this beautiful day, whether it be assisting actions, words of advice, or their willing support of being witness to the ceremony. There's a saying, it takes a village, and your village is present today, willing you on to the next stages of your life. As they've been constant in your past, so too will they be in your future. And if you couldn't see it coming, there's of course a third constant, hope. Shocker, I know, but hope can have different meanings in different circumstances. For today, I'm sure there's a hope that everything will go according to plan. In the beginning of your relationship, hope that the other person will want to have that first, second, and even third date. Hope that he finally pops the question, hopes that she says yes. And after today, hope that many days are as happy as this one, and that unhappy days are few and far between, for that we hope for you as well. So now everyone I'm sure is thinking, man, this guy's long-winded, I'm just trying to get to the drinks. But I assure you that after all this talk of wedding planning has a purpose. These constants, love, community, and hope, that have served you so well to this point will continue to serve you in your marriage when life becomes this difficult, as it will at times. Remember that even if one seems to disappear from your life, together that they are, in fact, always constant. Love of each other, support of family and friends, and hope of a plentiful life together. With this knowledge, it is time to declare yourself to each other. Victoria Ann Luckettville, you take Zachary Allen Stone to be your lawfully wedded husband from this day forward. Have and to hold, in good times and in bad, the richer for poor, in sickness and in health, will you love, honor, and cherish him for as long as you both shall. Zachary Allen Stone, do you take Victoria Ann Luckettville to be your lawfully wedded wife from this day forward, to have and to hold, in good times and bad, for richer for poor, in sickness and in health, will you love, honor, and cherish her for as long as you both shall. You have both come here today before friends, family, and God, and declared your intent to be wed in holy matrimony. Ryan, will you please hand Zach's ring to the Lord?
Finally, after everything we've been through, I couldn't be more certain The moment our paths crossed, you have surprised me, captivated me, and challenged me in ways that no human ever has. Not many people can honestly say they married the love of their life and their best friend, but I can. The way you fiercely love me and everyone around you without any hesitation is so inspiring. Yes, I appreciate how handsome you are and how you're built like an action figure, but that's just the icing on the cake. The absolute best part about you is your heart. Since I can remember, I have prayed for you. I prayed for a man of grace, ambition, strength, and loyalty. God answered my prayers when he brought me you. He knew exactly what we needed and when we needed it. When I look inside myself at what makes me feel safe, grounded, and hopeful, I see you. I love you because you make simple what this world tries to complicate. When I look at you, I see how beautiful our God is. You once told me tomorrow is never promised, so so it is important to love and appreciate the people in your life today. I and everyone around you have had the privilege of witnessing you live by that mentality every single day. I love that you're deeply kind and thoughtful. You're patient and generous, and you care so well for others. You're a great friend and an incredible teammate. You're understanding and compassionate, and you're one of the strongest people I know. I know you've experienced tremendous loss and pain in your life, yet you never let the world turn on you. Instead, you've chosen to be a light and continue to work hard and take care of business without ever complaining. You've taught me unbelievable resilience, and you've shown me that no matter what unimaginable scenario life throws at us, we will always be okay as long as we have each other. We are all so proud of who you are, and I know your dad is so proud of you too. On my best days, on my absolute worst, you never make me feel like I should be or need to be anyone but who I already am. And it is never lost on me the immense gift that is. Zachary, here are the promises I can joyfully give you today and forever. I promise to laugh with you, cry with you, and celebrate you in all of our victories. I will share in your dreams and support you in your goals. I promise to support your gym obsession, even when it's been a long day and I want you all to myself. If you have to carry the weight of the world on your shoulders, I will be there standing shoulder to shoulder with you. I promise to never stop dating you and reminding you every day how incomprehensibly handsome I find you to be. I promise to pray for you, and I promise to love you not only through my words, but through my actions. I promise to listen, especially when it's hard, because that's when I most need to hear what you have to say. I promise to notice the gifts you give me and appreciate them. Your kisses, your kindness, your patience, your humor, and your effort. I promise. I'm long-winded, I'm sorry. I promise to try to use recipes when fixing some of our meals. And I promise to bring the same enthusiasm to spicing up your life that I have with spicing up our dinner. I promise to use humor, reason, and humility when we must argue. And I promise not to keep score. I've seen your kindness and your strength, and I will strive to never take that for granted. I promise to remain patient with you. Not only when it's easy, but through tough times, like when we were riding together on the golf course and you had a bad day. Most importantly, I promise that even when we're old and gray, and in our sunniest and cloudiest times, I will look at you the same way that I do right now in this moment. Although I know I can think of a million intentional and sincere things I can promise you today, I know that I'm an imperfect person. But what I can promise is that I will love you every single day of all the ways I know how. Sometimes things will be easy, and sometimes things will be hard, but I will never stop showing up. And you have found my greatest friend. As I enter this life with you, I promise to be the first. No remakes, no take backs, and no do-overs. I did, I do, and I always will.
Ryan, will you please give a voice from Zach? Zach, I now ask you to place your ring on Corey's hand and exchange your vows. spouse's loving commitment in front of these witnesses.
I'm not sure how to follow that up. But...
Victoria, from the moment I met you, I knew that there was something different about you. At first, I wasn't quite sure what it was, but it didn't take you very long to figure it out. You have the most genuine heart of gold. You always see the best in everyone you meet, and you light up every room you walk into. Even on my darkest days, you never fail to show me that there was always light at the end of the tunnel. You make this life worth living. I truly don't know where I would be without you. When we first started dating 8 years ago, I was not in the best place. And I was not the man that I wanted to be. That didn't matter to you because you've always seen the best in me and the man that I was someday able to have. Throughout 8 years, I haven't always been easy. The road at times has been very bumpy, but I wouldn't trade any of that because it has made us stronger and has brought us right here in this moment. About to finally say I do. I want you to know that just because we are married, it doesn't mean that I'll ever stop loving you. I promise that I'll never stop caring about the little things. I promise that I'll always do my best to be positive and keep everything lighthearted in our relationship. I promise that when you're scared after watching a movie or an episode of Criminal Minds, that I'll hold your hand through the house when we should close up the house because you're too scared to walk alone. I also promise that when you're waking up in the dead sleep, because you think that you've heard a noise in the house, I will go and check out the house without an attitude, just so that you can rest easily. I promise that we'll never stop having our weekly date nights, even though our dinners only last 30 minutes, because we're both foodies, and we barely take a breath while we eat. But most importantly, I promise to never stop loving you for who you are. I promise I will always cherish your heart, and I will always protect you from harm or any negativity. I've known since I was 16 that you were the woman of my dreams, and the woman I would someday call my beautiful wife. Well, here we are 8 years later to the day. Happy anniversary, by the way. And I finally get to call you my wife. I love you more.
Zach, Tori, having proclaimed your love and commitment to one another in the sight of God and these witnesses, my pleasure, and with the power vested in me by God and the state of Texas, to pronounce you man and wife. Zach, you may now kiss your brother.
Hey, baby. No, Sarah wasn't ready for this. But something I can't resist. Oh, darling. What are you for this time? You were meant to be mine. It's a funny thing. So on top of this ring, you can have your house on a hill, and I'll build your little windmill. We can pray for time to stand still. Gotta love your soul. We can fill that home with kids. Sit back in rocking chair, reminisce. This ain't no temporary bliss. Baby, let me know, and we can grow on. Hey, baby. Hey, baby, I think I've changed my mind. What you doing for the rest of my life? Oh, what do you say? Oh, darling, wondering if you feel the same. Would you take my last name and say you love me so? But before that, you should know, baby, you need to know. You can have your house on a hill, and I'll build your little windmill. We can pray for time. time to stand still. Gotta love your soul. And we can fill that home with kids. Sit back and rock and chair and
first and foremost, we want to thank each and every one of y'all for coming and being here with us on our day. We truly couldn't be here without the love and support of each and every one here. I couldn't be more thankful to be part of y'all's family. We consider all of y'all to be our family. We really just can't thank you enough for being here.
We'll see you guys on the dance floor. So, I'm going to go forward with the line.
to Tori and Zach.
She's a
Mark worked with vim and brain because in sports, he was always willing to work harder than everybody else. She knew that if she wanted to earn a position, she had to work harder than the person that had that position, and she was always willing to do that. I was kind of farewell with her. I got some stories here that kind of lead into other stories. She went over to her neighbor's house one day, and his daughter was playing softball. My story was about that. And he was pitching her some wiffle balls, and he said, "Did Tori want to try to hit one?" I said, "I don't know, Tori, you want to hit a wiffle ball?" She said, "Okay." So I gave her the bat. The first one she hit right back to him. The second one over his head. The third one went on top of the house. He's like, "If she want to play softball, I don't know, Tori, want to play softball?" She goes, "Okay." So we go to practice, and we're in the dugout. The practice hadn't started yet. And they go, "Hey, the coach said, my daughter's going to be on the panel. We need somebody else to pitch. You might as well pitch." "Tori, you want to pitch?"
Service.
took over in the business school. She was one of the leaders on the sales team. They were in competition against schools like SMU, Baylor, UP, some other schools. And Tori helped lead that project. When it was over, she was done. Texas State University put Tori on the cover of the business school travel marketing brochure. She had such a great run. She did so well in the training program that there was a company called Federated Insurance that saw her in one of these competitions and recruited her, and she landed the position. She had to go to Minneapolis for 6 months. She was one, there were 17 people that were in this training program. Corey was one woman out of 16 guys. She hung in there. Jamie was a big part of that. They helped each other. Jamie was a little bit ahead of Corey. They became friends. So 16 men and Tori. After about a month, I remember Tori called me and said, "Dad, is chivalry, is that like a Texas thing or what? I've been here for a whole month. I love guys. I'm going to go for me." Yeah, I don't know, Coach. I guess so. She made it through there, and that was over. Federated put her in the position in the field. Within 7 months of her first year, became part of what's called President's Council, which is like top of the sales rep for that year. She got to go to the meetings, and she's been very, very successful. She's as far as beautiful and full personality, nobody knows her knows that. She's one of a kind, and she's been very successful in life and career. Most every coach has ever had, so I wish I had a daughter like her. Zach, your turn. Zach's quiet. Takes a while to get to know what I have him when he's receiving. He's thoughtful. Zach has always been there for my mom, brought her flowers on occasions, and even times when you wouldn't think he would, he did. He's very, very thoughtful. Supportive of that. I can't tell you how much I appreciate what you do for Tori. You let her be Tori. And that's a great thing. You just, two of y'all come together so well. I'd like to start this off right on. I'm so proud to be a part of your group now. You know, you've got 6 3 daughters and husbands and 6 kids that are all great and successful and happy and good people. Libby and I have a bunch of kids that are good people, and some people don't have that many that are all great people, you know, so we're thrilled about that. Back to Zach. He's quiet. We didn't know how smart he was. In high school, you wouldn't know, is what I understand. He got to college and decided to be with his daughter and his sister. He graduated cum laude. He's quiet, but he's really, really intelligent. And he didn't say much, but when he does, there's always substance behind what he has to say. He's a lot smarter than we do. He's hardworking and tough. He played football in high school. He got a scholarship to Cisco Junior College. And did the year there that he decided he wanted to be closer to Tori, so he went to Texas State and started a business at Texas State doing fences and landscaping. Zach paid his way through college doing side jobs and working hard, which is just amazing. I'm so proud of him for being able to do that. It's amazing. And obviously, Tori's beautiful and strong. Zach is handsome and strong. And we're so proud to have you a part of it. There for you when I need to leave. Thank you guys all for coming.
I'm just joking. The coolest thing about Tori is she's not scared to throw a football. Zach?
I've seen her.
Zach and I are not only cousins. He's like a brother I never had. And a lifelong best friend. The type of relationship Zach and I have always had has been very competitive, as you know. Whether it was who can eat most pancakes, or competing against sports, or whether it's wrestling in the yard, fighting, as long as we were better than each other, that's all that mattered. Zach, as you know, I will always have your back, bro. I love you. I know I'm going to be so proud of you. I'm a man you became. You truly are rock solid.
Please raise your glass and that's cheers.
Shaq and Tori.
you.